Welcome to The Debrief, where we talk with the Washington Examiner's top journalists about the headlines they're covering this week and where the story's going next. I'm Sarah Westwood, and I'm here with magazine editor David Mark. David, House Speaker Kevin McCarthy, he pulled some controversial Democrats off of some of their A committee assignments. Yeah. He pulled Adam Schiff off of House Intel, for example. Why did he do this? Tell us, give us the lay of the land of what happened.
Yeah, in a sense, there's not much surprise to this. This goes back almost 2 years now when Democrats, who then were in control of the House, kicked off of committees Marjorie Taylor Greene, Congresswoman from Georgia, and Congressman Paul Gosar from Arizona for some of the statements, actions, cartoons they put online. It's pretty controversial stuff. Republicans warned at the time, hey, when we get the majority, which is inevitable, it's gone back and forth several times in recent years, we're going to do the same thing. And sure enough, they did that to Congressman Adam Schiff, who's not just any member, but he's the former chairman of the House Intelligence Committee, also a major foe of former President Donald Trump, who led that impeachment effort, that first impeachment effort some time ago. There's Congressman Eric Swalwell, also from California, a Democrat, who Republicans have tangled with a bunch, and Congresswoman Ilhan Omar from Minnesota, who they have not yet been able to eject from her committee, Foreign Affairs. That's a little more complicated. That takes the vote of the full House, and some Republicans may not want to go on record doing that, so we'll see what happens there.
Yeah, that's my next question. How is this going down with House Republicans? Are some of them opposed to this, and does McCarthy have the votes to sort of exact the retribution that he wants?
Well, with Schiff and Swalwell, I didn't hear any objection from Republicans. Speaker McCarthy could just do that unilaterally, do it on his own, and they were gone.
Yeah.
As for Congresswoman Omar, that does take a full vote of the House, because it's not to get too into the weeds. The other Democrats are on what's called a select committee, which are appointed just by party leaders. The usual committee rosters have to be approved or disapproved by the entire House, so they would have to be an affirmative vote to kick her off of this Foreign Affairs Committee.
Adam Schiff, speaking of him,
yes,
has just announced that he is running for Senate in California. Do you think that he starts as the front runner in the Democratic primary?
Well, he certainly saw what was coming from the House. It's probably a good time for him to get out, particularly if Republicans were to maintain control of the House. He would just be left out in the cold. So no surprise there. I do think he's in a pretty strong position. One is he's just got a lot of name recognition. Agree with him or not, he's well known in the political world. Even people who follow politics tangentially is known as one of the biggest foes of former President Trump. And in California, a state where President Biden beat Trump almost 2-1, that goes a long way. Also, Schiff does have some Bay Area roots. He went to Stanford, he went to high school in the Bay Area. He's got family up there. I've noticed over the years he's been on the airwaves a lot, kept his name out there. He's running against, among others, we'll see it, but so far in the race, another California Congresswoman, Katie Porter, who's from the coastal area of Orange County, traditional Republican area that's changed a lot. She is trying to get her name out there. She's an acolyte of Senator Elizabeth Warren on the kind of populist left. She's known for going after bankers and other financiers and those types. It will be a tough race, no doubt about it.
Well, David, thank you so much for being here today.
Thank you.
You can get more reporting from David and the rest of the political team at washingtonexaminer.com.